Next, we are going to see Lagrange's mean value theorem. In the last class, we have discussed about the Rolle's theorem. So next, we are going to discuss about the Lagrange's mean value theorem. This theorem is also known as the law of the mean or simply mean value theorem. So the statement of this theorem is, let f of x be a continuous in closed interval a comma b and differentiable in the open interval a comma b, then there exists at least one point c belongs to the open interval a comma b such that f dash of c equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. So this is the statement of this theorem. Here you have to verify only two things, that is whether the given function is continuous or not. First condition we have to check is the function is continuous or not, and the second condition you have to check whether the function is differentiable on the open interval or not. If these two conditions are satisfied, then we can say a point belongs to the open interval a comma b such that f dash of c equal to f of b minus f of a equal to b minus a. So what is the main essence of this theorem is, suppose if you take a function y equal to f of x be the given function, so in which you are having two points, limiting points x equal to a and other end point x equal to b. In between you are having a point in which the tangent line, so this is the tangent line, and also you are having another line, which is the secant line. Okay, so this is the secant line, this is the point x is equal to c. So this theorem says that there is a tangent at the point c which is parallel to the secant line. So we are going to find such a point c using Lagrange's mean value theorem where the tangent is parallel to the secant line. You know that tangent line is the line which touches the curve exactly at one point, and secant line is the line which touches the curve exactly at two points. So we are going to solve the problems based on this theorem. You have to remember only two things: the function should be continuous on the closed interval a comma b, and the function should be differentiable on the open interval a comma b. Then there exists a point c such that f dash of c equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So you have to remember these things.